All right, welcome everybody. We're going to get started here in just a minute. And we're going to open up with a word of prayer, and then the Puffers are going to sing for us about an hour. So, and then we'll, I am going to take a free will offering. I hope that you know that. And so if you can, I want you to help give. And it'll be a blessing. That's at the end of the service. If you don't like their singing, don't give nothing.
Can we do it before we sing?
I know we're going to have praise tonight, but I have to tell you this. I was healed from cancer in this church 21 years ago, and I praise God.
Amen.
Praise God. Amen. Amen. Isn't that something? Praise the Lord for everything. He's good. And let's pray. Father, thank you for this day, the blessings that you've given us. We thank you for the opportunity that we have to be here tonight and to be in this service with all of these wonderful people. And we pray that you will bless each and everything. Bless the Puffers as they sing for us and testify to us. And we pray that Jesus Christ will be lifted up through their music. And just bless each one of us and our extended families. And we'll praise you for it, because in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right, here they are.
Thank you, Puffer. Hey, all right. We're ready. In our home church. Yes.
And it's great to see Pastor Nancy and Joe. That's so neat to see you.
Pastor Joe and Nancy.
Yes.
She had you the pastor.
All right.
And
Fellowship Baptist Church in a little town called Verona, New York, near the lake. They're very nice. We had a great time with you guys.
Yeah.
Happy Valentine's evening.
Amen.
Did you hear about the skeleton and he didn't send out any Valentine's cards? You know why? His heart wasn't in it.
Amen. Just as corny.
Yeah. Yeah, the offering just went up a buck right there. All right. We're going to get you involved in the first song. Isn't that wonderful? And isn't it wonderful?
Amen.
That's your part.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to sing from the first hallelujah to the last.
Amen.
Yeah, let's try again. From the pastor to good, but the rest of you. From the first hallelujah to the last.
Amen.
There we go.
Oh, wait, when it comes around, every time it comes around. Don't do it through the whole song.
Time we say amen, and when our hearts are joyful, hallelujahs ring again. In old camp meetings on the grass or temples filled by men, a saint shout hallelujah, and we all join in. From the first hallelujah to the last,
amen.
I'll praise the Lord and then I'll praise Him again, sharing the love of Jesus with all men. From the first hallelujah to the last,
amen.
Now don't you ever be afraid to say amen. Don't you ever hesitate to join right in. If you can't praise the Savior, then you'll be embarrassed when a saint shout hallelujah and the angels say amen. From the first hallelujah to the last,
amen.
I'll praise the Lord and then I'll praise Him again, sharing the love of Jesus with all men. From the first hallelujah to the last, from the first hallelujah to the last,
amen.
I'll praise the Lord and then I'll praise Him again, for sharing the love of Jesus with all men. From the first hallelujah to the last,
amen.
Hey. Man, that was good. We'd like to take you on the road with us, but we can't afford it. But anyway. Let's do this one not. Just to play some banjo music tonight, we're going to do a song here called Dear Old Dixie. It's just an instrumental, so nobody get hurt in this. Just an instrumental, Dear Old Dixie. Not Dear Old Winn-Dixie, but Dear Old Dixie. Ready, dear?
Mm-hmm.
Ah, let's get it. Thank you. do a little, well, kind of a lovey-dovey song tonight.
Well, you're going to do that
not
already?
No, not yours.
I'm not saving mine, yours.
This is for somebody else.
You did write this for me, right, honey?
Not this particular one, no.
Oh, you
did. Nor did I write it for anybody else. But. All right, this is one called, you know, I hope your wife is your best friend other than Jesus, amen?
Amen.
This is called You're My Best Friend.
Oh, you're going to have me do this one then.
Yeah, you can sing it to me.
Oh, I'm going to sing it to you. Okay.
We've had a lot of counseling and therapy in our marriage. That a psychologist told Darlene to just, like, you know, just turn loose of your mistakes and just let go. Don't hang on to them. And so she quit hugging me.
Yeah, I, you know, the Lord is our best friend, but, you know, the Lord brought us together, and this is kind of a really nice song, You're My Best Friend.
You place gold on my finger, you brought love. And to me, a reason to go on. You're my bread when I'm hungry. You're my shelter from troubled wind. You're my anchor in life's ocean, but most of all,
celebrated, was it 54 years? 54. The Puritans back there, they just celebrated. Yeah.
Wow, it's amazing. We'll never catch up with you, brother.
No, I don't think so.
We got 32 years going on here.
Going on,
we
yeah.
dated for 3 years because I want to make sure she could cook and play the piano, not necessarily in that order.
Sure.
But just been a wonderful wife, just a great wife, just a beautiful wife, a very, you know, gracious wife. Did I say everything you told me to? Well, we have a really good marriage, and we figured out the secret to a happy marriage.
Hey, somebody has it down.
No, we go out to eat. We go out to eat twice a week. She goes on Fridays. I go on Saturdays. But you got to be nice to one another, because see, your life is just a vapor. It's here today, and it could be gone tomorrow. Amen.
Right.
So you got to enjoy one another, and we do enjoy one another. Which brings us to a song. It's called A Little Puff of Dust. I wanted to put this out on radio. A Little Puff of Dust by the Puffers. Now, who wouldn't play that? They just put that on here to see what it was all about.
Okay, wait a minute. I gotta find it.
Okay,
see, don't. I never know where he's going because
if it's in your purse, we'll be here all night. So.
We just have little notes here and there.
You got it, dear?
I
just
got
like we
it
planned.
Somewhere.
Yeah. She'll find this and we'll have the invitation.
This particular song we use a track to, it was recorded in Nashville. So you're going to hear some really good playing down there. Let me see where it is. Okay. It's way up here. That's why I didn't. Okay. There we go.
I have it written on the inside of my eyelid, so I don't worry about that.
Okay. Professionalism. That's what we like.
Yes.
We're just down-home people.
The Lord, He is so vast and great. Man appears so small. He's faster than the speed of light. Well, you just barely crawl. He's already figured it out while you still try to adjust. Don't you know you're just a little puff of dust? Life is but a vapor. It's here then fades away. What you are tomorrow won't be what you are today. Oh, you're gonna get a bit older. You could fight it if you must. You're still gonna be a little puff of dust. You were made by God the Father. You're a little puff of dust. Your body is the temple. Yet the siding's gonna rust. If you're saved, you get a new one that won't wither or won't bust. But for now, you're just a little puff of dust. One day, proof your house could be gone. Your car may be on the blink. Your family might disown you. Your career begin to sink. When it comes to life in general, you got crumbs and not the crust. Well, don't forget, you're just a little puff of dust. Now don't you go to bragging about all the things you've done. You know others, they will speak of you after you move on. Just give the praise to Jesus, who is worthy of your trust. And don't forget, you're just a little puff of dust. You were made by God the Father. You're a little puff of dust. Your body is the temple. Yet the siding's gonna rust. If you're saved, get a new one that won't wither or won't bust. But for now, you're just a little puff of dust. You were made by God the Father. You're a little puff of dust. Your body is a temple. Yet the siding's gonna rust. If you're saved, you get a new one that won't wither or won't bust. But now you're just a little puff of dust. If you're saved, you get a new one that won't wither or won't bust. Now you're just a little puff of dust.
I was huffing puffing during that song. Things are not the same as they used to be. Let's do one of our older songs.
One of our older songs?
Yeah.
Now, which older one?
Nails and Thorns. I like that.
Well, that is a...
This is for Jerry and Sharon out there. This is Request Hour right here.
Oh, they
love we love our little friends. Thorns. We love our little friends out there, and we've been friends with them. We got married in their house. They had
yes,
a half moon
we
on
did.
It.
Yes, we did.
Got married. It was like in the afternoon sometime. I think maybe 2 o'clock in the afternoon when we were all awake. As we're musicians. You musicians, you want to get married late.
Yeah. Nails and Thorns.
And we do have CDs back there, and if you have a car that's new, anybody have a new car? We have thumb drives, like flash drives, you know, you can put that in there, and we don't instruct you on how to do that. You got to find that yourself, where that goes in. And so we have those, and we have song books.
This is another song that's, like we did early song this morning, that's in our songbook.
Yeah.
nails and thorns were all at Elizabeth on Calvary. I serve a risen Savior who died for you and me. The stone was rolled away, an empty tomb for all to see. Nails and thorns were all that was left on Calvary. Old Pilate washed his hands and said, I find no fault in him. Yet the crowd yelled even louder, shouting, crucify him. They said, give us Barabbas. He's the one that we want free. They tried to kill my Savior, but he won the victory. Nails and thorns were all that was left on Calvary. I serve a risen Savior who died for you and me. That stone was rolled away, an empty tomb for all to see. Now the people cried, come down from the cross and we'll believe. If you are who you say you are, if you're the King of Kings. Oh, but it could not be finished till he died for us alone. But death was not the victor. He's at the right hand of the throne. There is a throne. I serve a risen Savior who died for you and me. And that stone was rolled away, an empty tomb for all to see. Nails and thorns were all that was left on Calvary. Oh, nails and thorns on Calvary. One day he will appear, the Son of God unconquered, with a fist of iron he'll reign, and every knee shall bow, and every tongue confess his name. Nails and thorns were all that was left on Calvary. I serve a risen Savior who died for you and me. That stone was rolled away, an empty tomb for all to see. Nails and thorns were all that was left on Calvary. Nails and thorns were all that was left on Calvary.
Sometimes it's a violin,
sometimes it's a fiddle. If you came here for cultured music, I'm sorry. We are agricultured. Matter of fact, I graduated from agricultural school. I was voted person most likely to sack seed.
We got it.
I was voted person. All right, we're going to do something here called Leaning on the Everlasting Arms. Does that sound good to you?
Mm-hmm.
All right, we'll find out if it sounds good to them.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. This side up. Okay, I got it. Can't mess around with this thing. Thank you. Just buy one more instrument. And I taped her answer.
No. No. No, no.
Boy, he said it a few times.
I bought him a t-shirt, an early Valentine's gift, with Pinocchio on the shirt, saying, I'm not going to buy any more instruments.
The nose is about that long.
Okay, Wiseacre.
Uh-huh.
Let's do that, Colson.
Oh.
I'm the little ukulele, because we don't have a big one. Can you hear this okay? Okay.
Very good.
My dog has sleep. That's done. I'm going to be playing some high notes.
Okay.
There is a Church of Christ I used to belong to before as a Baptist, and they used to play ukulele like this. You'll get that in a minute, okay.
I got it.
Just waiting for that last person. Funny she should say that. She requested a song by Tracy Dart called You Can't Take It With You When You Go. Mm-hmm. Are you speaking of my musical instruments? Is that what you're speaking? Well, you're right.
I think the Lord's coming back soon. And
yeah, Pastor said this morning, everything's going to burn up. Yep, my instruments, your shoes.
Yeah, my shoes. I know.
Well, open closet for somebody.
Yeah.
Anyway. You can't take it with you when you go. How true that is.
Alright, here we go.
You can have my car if you need a ride.
You can have my house and all the furniture inside.
Make yourself at home, keep it for your own. Don't you know, 'cause I can't take it with me when I go. You can have my guns, you can have my gold,
and all the freeze-dried food, and the vitamins I never sold.
The VCR, the DVD, now don't you know, 'cause I can't take it with me when I go. No, I can't take it with me when I go. 'Cause when you go, you've got to leave it all behind. I'm leaving in the twinkling of an eye, and I can't take it with me when I go. You can have my spot on the family pew. And if they fit, you can have my suit and Sunday shoes. If you're not saved, you'll need them all. Don't you know? 'Cause I can't take you with me when I go.
That's right.
No, I can't take you with me when I go. 'Cause when you go, you've got to leave it all behind. I'm leaving in the twinkling of an eye, and I can't take you with me when I go.
Try this with us.
I can't take it with me when I go.
'Cause when you go, you've got to leave it. Ready now?
'Cause when you go, you've got to leave it all behind.
I'm leaving when?
I'm leaving in the twinkling of an eye, and I can't take it with me when I go. I'm leaving in the twinkling of an eye, and I can't take it with me when I go.
You ready? We got a bass player in our church. He's just terrific. And not you, buddy. Sit down. Tony Adams. And we've been putting together a little flash drive thing with 30 songs that I wrote during the COVID period. It's called Puffers Have Gone COVID. I mean, Puffers Have Gone Acoustic.
But this one you didn't write during the COVID period, I don't think.
No. I wrote this for you, dear. This mm-hmm. is your song I'm doing for you
so
tonight.
So precious, honey.
Another Valentine's song. Isn't it good?
Flowers bloom in the spring, but they don't make me sing like you do. I thank God for you. Clouds float in the sky, but they won't lift me high like you do. And I thank God for you. The Lord, He knew just what I needed. When it comes to my companion, I know I've been completed. I've told you so many times, you must believe it's true, my love. I thank God for you. Friends, they make me smile, but only for a while, not like you do. I thank God for you. I've loved you from the start. No one could touch my heart like you do, and I thank God for you. Lord, He knew just what I needed. When it comes to my companion, I know I've been completed. And I told you so many times, you must believe it's true, my love. I thank God for you. Every day of my life, I feel love for you, my wife. And I'm grateful for all the things you do. When problems, they arise, no one holds on tight like you do. I thank God for you. When tough times get me down,
no human sticks around like you do. I thank God for you. The Lord, He knew what I needed. When it comes to my companion, I know I've been completed. And I've told you so many times, you must believe it's true, my love. I thank God for you.
Thank you, honey.
I love you. Every day I love you a little bit more. And thank you, Tony, for doing that, buddy. I think the Lord's coming back soon. I just see some things happening. Of course, And I think He is coming soon, don't you?
Amen. Yeah.
And that just happens to be the name of the next song we're going to do. He's coming soon.
Amen.
Music store up here. Except we're not selling anything. Yeah. Before we were married, by the way, and I just want to say I had no idea. I had no idea that Darlene was musically inclined. I didn't know she liked musicians. But I always liked her. She used to work with my mom. She was in a carpool with my mom. And always liked her, always asked questions about, Mom, who is that? Who is that in the back seat?
Little did I know.
I was watching you from afar. He's coming soon. This is a great old song, old song, taken from a bluegrass song called Ashes of Love. So here we go. We have the Lord's love, amen?
Amen.
Oh, He's coming soon, and there's no doubt I'm gonna leave this world with a shout. Oh, sin will be gone, and things will be right. Keep looking up, He may come tonight. Oh, trumpets will sound, and those in the ground saved by the blood will be held and bound. Then that I'm gonna be their brother, now how about you? He's coming soon, and there's no doubt I'm gonna leave this world with a shout. Sin will be gone, and things will be right. Keep looking up, He may come tonight. Savior's feet. It may be in the morning, it may be at noon. I don't know when He's coming, but I know He's coming soon. Oh, He's coming soon, and there's no doubt I'm gonna leave this world with a shout. Oh, sin will be gone, and things will be right. Keep looking up, He may come tonight. Yeah.
Guitar over here.
Okay. Which one are we doing?
Well,
Lonesome Valley.
Okay.
Tony.
Yes.
You know this. Come on up here.
Yeah, I thought.
I may or may not know it.
We'll know in just a few seconds.
I'll have to figure it out real quick.
You can do that, Tony.
Here's a hint. It's in the key of E. Does that help you?
That helps me quite a bit. I can play one note.
I don't know.
It's called Lonesome Valley.
Lonesome Valley.
Lonesome Valley.
You know that one?
Never heard of it.
Tell you what it was. It's the same thing.
He seems to just follow right along.
Amen.
Are you glad you live in America?
Amen.
I'm glad you do too, because we wouldn't have a crowd if you didn't live in America. And we're going to do a song called The Greatest Country. We do live in the greatest country.
Amen. I'm wondering, CD's back there.
Yeah.
What's going on?
They got their own show.
We have one of the best churches in Florida.
Amen.
And we've been all over too. We've been everywhere, and we've been all over America and Texas.
Well, we did.
They got their own thing going in Texas, man. I was born in Texas. Actually, I was born. I got my papers. Yes, sir. I was born in Waco. Waco. Got a bum rap there, but you ready?
I think I am.
I wrote this song, but I didn't write the intro. You'll probably recognize the intro. Down with the flag of the Taliban, up with the stars and stripes. I love to see old glory waving after a long, hard fight. Oh, I love to stand for freedom. I love to stand for right. And we could stay the greatest country in the world if God is still on our side. Down with the devil and his angels, up with Jesus Christ. Praise to his power and glory and the love that he sacrificed. I love to stand for the Savior. He stood and paid the price. And we can stay the greatest country in the world if God is still on our side. But some are waiting for us to slip and fall. The Savior is saying, you better heed the call. So up with the sound of the bugle, down with the spirit of fear. I'd love to see us standing tall like the pilgrims and the pioneers. And
And they sailed over to this country and settled in this cradle land. We've got to build on the solid rock and put it back in God's great hand. But some are waiting for us to slip and fall. The Savior is saying, you better heed the call. So keep on waving, old glory. Keep on fighting the fight. You know the captain said we can take that hill, and the victory's yet in sight. Well, we're right in the heat of the battle. Sin is spreading far and wide. But we can stay the greatest country in the world if God is still on our side. We can stay the greatest country in the world if God is still on our side.
As Christians, we need to stand up for what we believe in. Amen. I love the flag. I love America. I love Jesus. Here's one called, Where Do You Draw the Line?
Mm-hmm. We're talking a little.
Yeah, we. I will later.
I got to get ready, honey. Fill in the blanks.
Oh, I have to fill in the blanks. Okay. Well.
Never mind, I'm ready.
Oh, you're ready. Okay. I'm glad you're ready. Because I'm trying to get ready, too.
Where do you draw the line?
Yeah.
We tried to write something that has a message to it. Except for this is it.
Some people have their agendas, seeing that laws get passed. Many are against the word of God. Those seem to always move fast. When it comes to facing Jesus, I wouldn't want to be in their shoes. When the judgment falls, I wonder what God will do. Where do you draw the line? Where do you draw the line? If you weren't even a Christian, where would you draw the line? Where do you draw the line? Where do you draw the line? If you weren't even a Christian, where would you draw the line? Leaders are concerned about your health. They say they got the plan, but they wouldn't use it for themselves. I don't understand. Taking away your weapons and saying they are wrong for you. But if your house is invaded, what are you supposed to do? Well, tell me, where do you draw the line? Where do you draw the line? If you weren't even a Christian, where would you draw the line? Ooh, I'm gonna carry my Bible. If anybody asks me why, 'cause I know God is in control. Even after I die, and the Lord told us to be fruitful and multiply, it's true. A man for a woman for a man, know all the plan will do. So tell me, where do you draw the line? Where do you draw the line? If you weren't even a Christian, where would you draw the line? Where do you draw the line? Where do you draw the line? If you weren't even a Christian, where would you draw the line?
Well, go ahead. gonna get Darlene to sing a song here for us right now, and I think she sings this better than anybody I know on the stage at this time. No, I think she sings it better than anybody I know. I really love the way she sings this song. I see.
You mean I sing it better than you?
Yes. I tried it in your key once. It didn't work very good.
Yeah. How many know the old song?
Just sing like a bird.
How many know the old song? It is no secret what God can do. And some of you don't know our testimony, I don't think. And Bob has mentioned how he came to know the Lord out of the nightclubs. I came to know the Lord out of religion. You can go to church all your life and believe in God and believe in Jesus, but really not know what it is to trust the Lord as your Savior. And because of that, I was doing my own thing for many years, kind of going in the wrong direction. I think the Lord was trying to get my attention for a long time, but he finally got my attention. And when he did, I said, Lord, just show me what you have for me. And 2 months later, now I had seen Bob back before we were both saved when he was playing in the nightclubs. And I always liked his music. I'd take different dates there, and I never thought we'd ever be together. But anyway, so I knew who he was, and I knew from being in the carpool with his mom that he quit the nightclubs and he was in church. But at that time, I wasn't saved, so I didn't understand why did he quit the clubs. But when I came to know the Lord, of course, I'd lost track of his mom. But I'm looking for the specialty item one day, and I went to the first store. And they didn't have it. And I went to the second store and they didn't have it. It was kind of a specialty cheese item. And so I'm on my way home. Now I didn't have company coming or anything, but I think the Lord does this in our lives. I went to that third store I'd never ever been in. Thought, try one more store, it's close to home. I'm strolling down the aisle. Now he had become a baker for an interim period, which I had no idea. He stepped out with his baker's outfit and hat on, the whole thing, and said and greeted me, and I'm like, who are you? The last time.
What is this?
But that's how the Lord brought us together. And some say that I never did find the special item, but some say I came out with a large meatball. What do you think? But, you know, I just said all this to say, God has a plan. I think he has a sense of humor, too. God has a plan for each and every one of us, you know. It just makes me think of that when I say, it is no secret what God can do.
Take him at his promise. Don't
more song. How's that? I'm just timing it.
Let's do the mandolin.
Have you ever played the mandolin?
We're going to play that tonight.
Okay.
Well. It's funny you should say that. Where is it?
Yeah.
I got it written. Mandolin left turn. I should have. What a wonderful crowd tonight. You guys are great. You are the most underpaid crowd I've ever seen.
I wanted to say before we finish this last song, and just tell you a little bit what's on the table. We have a number of CDs, but we also have a live DVD that we did. Our radio station in Syracuse sponsored a homecoming, and we decided that was a time to do a live DVD. And we also have a DVD. Bob has a DVD of instructional guitar. If you know a few chords on the guitar, it shows you how to do finger picking style. We have songbooks, we have soundtracks, and I'm not going to have them forever, but if you want to try to sing our songs, we have them for a while yet. What else do we have there? Flash drives. Those that don't have CD players in your car, we have flash drives.
We got everything on that back table. We got coffee stains on that back table. If you're going to talk about an old song, this is one of the best old songs I know. Always love this song.
And it makes me think of my parents and loved ones who've gone on. My parents, I had wonderful parents. You can have wonderful parents, but they weren't saved until I got saved. And they came to know the Lord in their 70s. And they've gone on to heaven. And I think about them when we do this song, Where the Roses Never Fade.
I'm going to the city where the streets of gold are laid, where the tree of life is blooming and the roses never fade.
Slows down, but music is good. And by the way, you know, we have this every Sunday. Darlene plays our piano, and he plays the guitar, and Tony plays the guitar, and Brother Roberto leads the singing every Sunday, except when they're out of town. And so Come and visit us. Come and visit. I mean, I know that you've heard about Jesus, and isn't it wonderful when you have an encounter with Jesus Christ and you've met Him? You can be religious as you want to be, but if you don't have that Christ in your heart, if you don't have that personal relationship with Jesus Christ, you know, life gets pretty dull. Yeah. I think everybody here is saved, but I just want to tell you, and for those watching today, tonight on Facebook Live, I want to say especially to them that if you've never trusted Jesus as your personal Savior, we'd love for you to now, if you realize you're a sinner, just ask Jesus to forgive you of your sin and come into your heart and save you. And He sure will. Amen. He did me and He did all of these folks, and He will save you. And so what a blessing to be able to be here. If you've never tried to write a song or play an instrument, you don't know how wonderful this is, that He's able to write all these songs and they're able to play all these instruments. And I've done both of them. It's not easy. It's hard work. But what a blessing it is when we have these. God has really blessed this church tremendously. And it's just wonderful that I get to be the pastor here after all of these years in the ministry. That the Lord just put me here. You never know why, but He does. He just puts you where He wants you, I guess. And that's where I'm at, where I want to be anyway. And I'm sure He wants me to be here. We are, you know, we're in the business of being a Baptist. You heard that, I saw this on Facebook or somewhere. You know how it is. And they said, the preacher got up and he said, you know, we're not going to have any more dinners at church because of this COVID-19. And this little old boy, he asked his mama on the way home, said, does that mean we're not Baptist anymore? And we're Baptists, and so as soon as this is over with, we're going to have a dinner in the back. And everybody's welcome. Isn't that great? Everybody. And you come, and we got coffee, and we got every kind of a drink you want. Well, no, not every kind. We don't have the hard stuff, but we got a lot of good stuff. And we got food, you know, all kinds of food. We got dessert, and so everybody be sure and stay. The only thing we don't have is a lot of space. We have limited space, but we don't care. We're going to sit down and eat, so here y'all come back with us. And we're going to take a love offering. I know there's always a lot of people that would like to give something that you normally maybe don't give in the offerings at this church, but you'd like to give it to them. And every dime that comes in will go to their ministry, everyone. Unless you put a check in there for me, and then it won't. I always have to try to joke around, but I do love these people, and they are wonderful, and I'm glad they're part of us. They're part of us. So I'm going to ask Roberto. He's our jack of all trades, and he's going to pray, and we're going to pray for this offering because we need it bad, so pray for it. And so we don't need it bad. I just made that up. But anyway, we're going to take one so that you'll have an opportunity to give if you desire. Brother Roberto.
Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank You so much for everything that we have heard and seen tonight. We thank You so much for the Puffers, Lord, and their ministry, not only to this church, but, Lord, all that they do around the country, Lord, with their singing. God, we pray that You'll continue to bless them, Lord, continue to be with them as they go, even though with everything going on, we know that they're not able to go as much as they would like. But God, we ask that You would open the doors for them so that they would continue to do ministry, Lord, wherever You would leave them, Father. God, we ask that You would bless the rest of this service, Lord. May You be honored and glorified. And I pray that You would also just bless the time of fellowship. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. God bless you now as you give. Thank you. we're going to be dismissed, and we'll go back and eat, and be sure and stay and enjoy a time of fellowship together.